If you don't think quivers, new arrows, shields, and dual wielding are enough, then you're gonna love what's in store for the day. Let's get started. That's right, Dennerbone has made it official. We can now have a mini-map at all times on screen, while still having the ability to fight, mine, shoot, or do anything in Minecraft. Is there anything else they could possibly add to Minecraft that could be this shocking? And we're back. If you didn't already know, I'm Andrew from Fire Rocker Studios. You guys are rockers, and as of the recording of this video, it is currently June 10th. Earlier today, Dennerbone released this GIF via Twitter, and he also stated, "I was trying to get the arm behind this, but I'm giving up for now. Floating map it is." So it's official, we are getting a brand new animation for when you hold a map, which currently, it's kinda weird since we don't have two hands, you can't have it on one hand, you pretty much have it on two. So if I go into first person mode and scroll into it, you can actually see I have my left and my right hand kinda holding it like this, and that is the system that we're stuck with right now. It's really cool, cause we can now pretty much have it set to be a mini map. You can have it on your offhand or your main hand slot depending what type of setting you want to do, and that could be either your left or your right side depending which settings you have set to your main and your offhand. Keep in mind, offhand is not left, offhand is whatever you want it to be. I think default offhand will be left, but of course you can switch it if you want to be a lefty as your priority. In other news, Dennerbone was asked via Twitter, "When do you think we can speak to each other in game instead of using Skype or TeamSpeak?" He answered by, "I don't think we can do a better job at voice chat than those, so we'd rather let you just use those for now. Sorry." So I guess it's official, we're not gonna be getting voice chat anytime soon, but anything is possible. Mojang did get bought out by Microsoft, and they do have a lot of money, so they might eventually be able to invest in an audio type of interface for Minecraft. But for now, we are stuck with the typing chat. He also tweeted, "You won't see both hands ordinarily in Minecraft. This was just a screenshot of a buggy stage of development that I found funny." He was referring to the glitchy picture that he released earlier, as you can see right here. But that would be pretty cool, being able to release your hand like that, so it's funny when you see these little glitches. That just goes to show you guys, everything is still heavily being developed, and we're only in a small stage in 1.9. We haven't even gotten a snapshot, so... Ooh. Oh, and you know what that sound means? It's time for our brand new segment called...
Today's Message of Awesome!
So, Andrew 2, what is the new message for today? Well, I'm glad you asked, Andrew 1. Let's start with Minecraft. So, the very first 1.9 snapshot may be dropping any day now. We asked viewers to share their thoughts, and after reading through hundreds of comments, it seems that about 85% of people love what they're seeing, and the other 15% are kind of on the fence. Guess we'll have to wait till the snapshots come out so we can see what people really think. In other news, I was on Facebook last night, and I saw this weird little futuristic gadget, which I couldn't believe it was real. But it's actually a thing, and it's set to release this summer. Now, they're not sponsoring me, nor are they paying me anything. They didn't even contact me. I just found them and wanted to share this really cool product with you guys. So it's like a digital credit card where you sync all of your credit cards and debit cards into it. I think you can sync anything else as a barcode and a strip. It's really weird. It's got its own LED screen, which is crazy. And I don't know, if you guys are more interested in it, I'll see if I can find a link for it, and I'll put it in the description below alongside the other links of what I talked about today. Now, if you thought that was cool, this is gonna blow your mind. Now, for all you Minecraft fanboys, I'll give you a hint. It's got an LED screen, it's circular, it kinda reminds you of Redstone because, well, that's right, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Game Band. I've shown it to you guys before, and it's absolutely awesome. They're backed by Mojang themselves, and unlike the other guys, they actually sponsored us, so for that, we thank you. Check out their epic brand new video, they just released it. I have the link to it in the description below. They had actual Mojang employees in it, and it looks so professional and amazing because, well, they are professional and they are very amazing. So if you guys are interested in getting your own Game Band, links are down below. Ultimate Minecraft gadget. And that wraps up today's Message of Awesome. Back to you, Andrew 1. Thanks for the message, Andrew 2. That is why I love having a little clone of myself. So, talking about the 1.9 mini-map feature, one of the really cool things about it, Dennerbone made it very clear that you could switch through anything in your offhand slot by simply hitting F. That's right, the F key. Now, How does that work? Well, your offhand slot will automatically switch with what is in your main hand. So right here is my taskbar. I kind of made it a little bit bigger so you guys can see what I mean. And it's a little bit complicated to explain just because I'm not a 1.9. So let's just say my left hand is currently set as my offhand and that I have a map in my offhand. Now, I don't really have anything where I could show you as a good example. It's very complicated to explain what I'm talking about because of the fact that you really need to be in the other update. Bitterbone has expressed how annoying it is to explain this to people just because it's super confusing doing it through text or doing it in general if you're not in the actual update, but it'll make sense when the update comes out. So right now, let me hit I so I can show you this. Right here is my main taskbar, whatever you guys call this, your hotbar, your anything, and you could switch through everything. Now, in the 1.9 update, I'm gonna have my main hand, which is the one, which could be your left or your right. Right now, my main hand is, let's just, for example, my right hand, and pretend I had a hand that was on the left side, which is my off hand. Main hand is on the right, left hand is my off hand. So, if I have a map on the left side, which is my off hand, and I wanna switch from what's currently in my main hand, which is right now my sword, I would hit F. And after I hit F, it would switch it, then I would have my map on the right side, which I could easily just switch through from, let's say, right now, I have a map on the right. So, right now I could switch through anything. So if I want to select the map again, now keep in mind, at this point I have my sword on the left. If I want to go back to having the map there, I go over in my taskbar like I currently just did and I have the map. Keep in mind, this is why the 1.9 and every update before has to be fully updated. When I look down, I am holding it with both hands. And when, of course, in general when I'm walking, it's in the middle. Whereas in the 1.9 update, it's going to be either on the right or the left side because, well, it's going to be on my main or offhand. So when I'm walking around, I'm going to have my map on the right side, but I want to switch it with what's on the left side, which is a sword. I hit F, it'll switch the map to the left side, it'll move the sword back to the right, and then I could switch from my sword, since it's back onto the right side, to anything else. So, in theory, when I'm walking around, I'll have my mini-map on the left side and my sword on the right. That way, I can see where I'm going, and I also am protected. Now, if I see that there's a, a PvPer that wants to kill me in front of me, what do I do? These are the steps. I would first hit F. Bam! It would switch my sword to my offhand, and it would switch my map to my main hand. Where from there, I would scroll through anything here, maybe a bow, or maybe an ender pearl. So bam, I now have an ender pearl in my main hand, and my sword in my offhand. I would then again hit F, which would switch what is currently my pearl, which is on the 9th spot in my hotbar, and it would put it in the slot for what is my offhand, which actually will appear in here, but this is the creative menu, not the survival menu. But yeah, so it'll switch it to that, and then of course my sword will be moved to the right side, and then the pearl will be moved to the left. Now, why do I want that? Well, because the pearl is a feature that you can right click with. Now, of course, I'm in creative right now, so I can't actually release it, but that's just an example of a really cool combat strategy. And if I want to go ahead and switch to having my minimap again after I'm done fighting, I will hit F again, which will move my sword from my offhand to my main hand. Or actually, we'll do it backwards. We'll switch my sword from my main hand to my offhand. We'll put the pearl back on my main hand. I will then scroll through whatever I want. And of course, I want to get the minimap. I'll have the minimap on my right side, which is my main hand. Hit F again, put it as my offhand slot, and I can continue walking while having full control of my sword or a pickaxe or whatever I want to be in my main hand. So that's how it works. Very complicated. I hope you guys understood what I was saying. Let's move on. Going over the other things that are coming out in the 1.9 update, since we pretty much talked about everything with the minimap, we have dual wielding, quivers, new arrows, and let's not forget about shields. That's right, we're getting all these awesome new features, and there's just so much awesomeness. Bitterbone also made it official a couple of days ago that you will be able to both block and attack. For people that got really mad that you can't block with a sword anymore, let me show you what I mean. So, I'm trying to find my sword. There's my sword. So, if you right-click in the 1.8 update or before, you can block just like that, and you can hit by left-clicking. So, right-clicking blocks, left-clicking hits. Now, he removed the ability to block with a sword or right-click and be able to have a feature in the 1.9 update with the sword. The sword only. That's the only thing he removed. Because of that, people got really mad. Keep in mind, you can have a shield in your offhand and you can have a sword in your main hand. And again, we don't know 100% that the shield is going to be used for blocking, but we're almost certain, since he already confirmed that shields are coming, that you will be able to block with a shield. And he has stated that you will be able to both hit and block at the same time. So most likely, you'll be able to have your shield, be able to block by right-clicking, and you'll still be able to hit at the exact same time with your sword. So that's one of the reasons why he's really frustrated. A lot of people are giving him a lot of hate for it, and they just don't know the update just yet because, well, it's not out yet. So don't complain, guys, if you're looking at his Twitter and be like, why haven't you done this and that? Wait till the first snapshot comes out, and of course, you gotta wait till the update comes out to officially know what's gonna be coming out. Now, guys, let me know, what do you guys think about shields being added? Do you think that's awesome? Do you not? I know for years, I've been playing Minecraft since the beginning of 2011. I think the end of 2010 actually is when I actually bought the game. So ever since then, people have been asking for shields, and I can't believe it, but I guess it's true. People will always complain about change. So guys, I want to know what you think. Do you love the shields? Do you hate the shields? We don't know much about them, but what do you think at least about the idea? Let me know in a comment down below. I really do look forward to seeing what you guys have to say. But if there's anything for sure, that is that PvP will be changed forever, and I personally think it's for the better. PvP's been the same for years. I mean, they've added a couple new things, but this is changing the game. It's no longer about having a sword and switching to something else. It's about having two things. You literally double the amount of skill, and then that's not even it. It's not just a matter of having two things, it's the combinations. You don't just hit twice, you know? People are like, oh, we wanted to be able to hit with two swords. No. It's not hitting with a sword and hitting with a block by, you know, left click or right clicking. When you right click, you're not gonna be hitting with a block, so it's not just a stupid double hit feature. It's literally a double feature. Whatever that feature is gets to use its feature, so you can have a potion on your offhand and a sword on your main, be able to hit and be able to shoot that splash potion or throw the splash potion, whatever you call it. Same thing with a nether pearl, or you can place a block. A lot of awesomeness is coming from this, and I'm really excited and can't wait to report more on it. Guys, make sure to leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think of the 1.9 update, and your comment could be featured in my next video. Also, here's a little clue of what you guys can expect in tomorrow's video. Well, that was something. If you guys think you know what tomorrow's video is going to be about, then leave your suggestion in a comment down below and tune in tomorrow to see if you were right. Also, guys, if you like how today's video was edited, including the little skits, segments, and effects that I added, and would like to see all my daily content be just as high quality, then hit that like button and comment any of your suggestions that you have for possible future segments and such. I am also very excited to announce that daily uploads have returned to the Fire Rocker Studios channel. Just letting you know, though, there won't be a video tomorrow. The first video of the non-stop upload train will come out this Saturday, and a new video will follow every single day after that, unless if maybe there's a huge project that I'm doing and it requires 2 days worth of editing or something crazy like that. I'm actually using the next 48 hours after recording this video to write, film, edit, and schedule upload at least 2 videos in advance. They're gonna be absolutely amazing, and I can't wait for you to see them. Oh, and before I go, make sure to watch the new Game Band video like I said earlier. It features Smojig members and is freaking awesome. But yeah, guys, that's about it for me. Remember to check out the description, hit that button for a subscription, and I will see you tomorrow.